What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. And in today's video, we are going to be discussing my major takeaways from Matt Patricia's interview. What he had to say about guys like Jamie Collin, Jared Davis, Matthew Stafford, and DeAndre Swift. Let's get it started. Welcome, everybody, to another video. Glad you guys are here. And today, I usually would say, let's go check out the comment of the video. But we don't have that because, as you guys can see, it's blank. Yeah, I don't know where I put my marker. So I'm gonna, I found my marker. Look, I just found it. Hold up. I just found my marker as I'm not even playing. I just found it. Okay, well, let's write something down then. So as you guys can see, as it says on the top, Sunday, August 16th will be our first live show on Fan to Fan Network. I believe it is planned for 4 p.m. I do have a comment from Hungry Panda that we will be using on here very soon, Hungry Panda. I don't think I forgot about you. We'll definitely be putting your comment on here soon. I just haven't came up with my answer yet, so I want to come up with that before I use that comment for the video. But the question of today is this. What is your favorite? I cannot spell favorite. What is your favorite restaurant?
Bruh.
Restaurante. Did I spell that wrong? I don't know. What is your favorite restaurant? It could be fast food, slow food. I don't care. What is your favorite restaurant? Put that in the comments below. Some people live in places where they have restaurants that we don't have where I live or where maybe you live. So I'm really curious to see the answers that we have to this one. Now let's get into today's video. And I think there was a lot of really interesting answers. So that's why we're doing today's video. And yesterday we did a video where I took all these little interviews and kind of put them into one. Well, I don't have the clips today, but simply Matt Patricia did this press conference. I feel like there was some really interesting takeaways. So I put them into a video. And I think you guys would be really curious to hear some of these answers if you guys have not seen the video yet. And kind of just my thoughts on things that he had to say. So we're going to start off with the very beginning where he talked about the 90-man roster and them keeping a 90-man roster, which he said was unique, and it was unique because not a lot of teams decided to keep a 90-man roster. A lot of teams actually did cut down, but he kept a 90-man roster, and he gave pretty much the same answer that Bob Quinn did as to why they did that. It's because they feel like they have players to offer, players that they brought in that they wanted to see a little bit. Now, sure, they're not going to get to see all of these guys for practice, but they are able to see these guys for strength and conditioning, so it's better than nothing. Now, the way that he described how they're doing practice is different than what I thought. You know, they're doing the split squad, which you have to. However, they're basically breaking it down into four different groups. They're breaking this into four groups, and then they're going to slowly start to expand and bring it all together until they get to the 80-man roster when that happens. But for now, they've actually broken it into four groups that come in throughout the day. They have also broken in these groups into different positions and by time they've been in the league. So you're getting a mix of veterans, different positions. That way, there's not all the same people in one, and you're getting a good mix of different guys that are getting to meet each other and work with each other. Jared Davis actually talked about this yesterday's video, how he said that one thing that he misses is that he's not able to see everybody. Well, soon that will be the case, but for now, they have broken it into four groups. Next thing they had to talk about with Jamie Collins, and you guys know I'm a Jamie Collins junkie, okay? I've been really hyped on Jamie Collins for this season, and that's probably the player I'm most excited to see on the defensive side of the ball because Jamie Collins is an absolute monster. He's just so good. He just does everything we need defensively. And Matt Patricia talked about Jamie Collins because someone asked what his role would be on the Detroit Lions defense, why they liked him. And Matt Patricia said this. He looks at it from the quarterback's perspective. This was an interesting answer. He said, I look at it from the quarterback's view. When a quarterback looks at the defense and he's always starting to think to himself, where is Jamie Collins and what is he doing? That element is what makes Jamie Collins so great, and that's what they love about him, that they can move him everywhere, but when the quarterback is on the field and he's looking around at the defense, they always have to know where Jamie Collins is, and that's absolutely facts. Jamie Collins is arguably the best pass coverage linebacker in the league, and obviously that on its own will make you scared, but his ability to also be a great pass rusher, so now you have to know, okay, well, is he coming to me, or is he going to blitz, is he going to drop into coverage? You're always kind of focused on this guy. It's just someone that you have to kind of keep in the back of your mind. Like offensively, you know, when you have all these weapons, and you kind of have to think, okay, well, hold up. We can't forget about Marvin Hall because he will burn us deep with that speed. Now you're thinking as an offensive player, as a quarterback, where's Jamie Collins? Jamie Collins could be a guy that's jumping on these routes, that's bringing pressure. He could line up at every different position, so we have to find him. And that's just another thing that a quarterback has to deal with. I thought that was a beautiful explanation. He also said his talent was off the charts. I don't know if he took that from me or if I took that from him, but I say that a lot. I find myself saying that a ton. So, hey, Matt Patricia, look, we have something in common. We say words. Don't know why that's something we have in common. Matthew Stafford, because someone brought up that Matthew Stafford was having a career the year last year when he was healthy, and then obviously he got injured, and how Matthew Stafford looked so far. Now, clearly they haven't had any practices or anything like that, so they really don't know too much about him, but he says Matthew Stafford is a football junkie, and he says no one works harder than Matthew Stafford. Now, obviously you just say that sometimes, but I feel like I could believe that. Matthew Stafford works extremely hard, you can tell. And he says he loves getting calls from Matthew Stafford when he's saying, hey, we're going to go grab these guys. We're going to be working out. We saw some of those workout clips this offseason. Him and Swift, him and Nauta, you know, him and some receivers, him and Victor Bolden putting in work. Matt Patricia said he was the hardest working player that he knows, and he'll be ready to go for next season. He actually said back in the spring, he told him, hey, I'm ready to go. I'm good to go. I'm healthy. And he knows his body very well. So definitely some high praise for Jamie Collins and Matthew Stafford. Well-deserved praise. He talked about DeAndre Swift a little bit, just kind of saying that there's a lot of things that he would have to learn, a lot of things that go into being a rookie for every single rookie. And he said that he's been working really hard, just like everybody has. Through veterans and the new young guys, been acting like veterans. Everybody's been very professional and ready to go, which is huge. And I feel like you've seen that with the players that Lions bring in. Lions bring in professional players. They're ready to go. Okay, these are those guys that show up to game day and they're ready to play. Then he had to talk about a few things that they're doing, you know, for the COVID and everything like that, like the tracking systems. And I guess they're wearing little rings that tell them about symptoms and things like that. Crazy, okay? So they got all these little, you know, technical thing and technology things that are like all these fancy things that tell them what's going on within their body, how healthy they are. And yeah, they have a lot of crazy stuff going on there. So I'm sure they have a lot of ways to keep those guys healthy, which is huge, and they're just trying out new things to make sure that everybody is okay. He talked about calling guys like Sean Payton and Doug Peterson when they were tested positive and hoping everything is okay there. He talks about, you know, like, hey, it's football. At the end of the day, you want to make sure everybody is healthy. I completely agree with that for sure. He also says that Wade will use their stadium as scrimmages. So I guess other teams around the league have had this idea that they could scrimmage, you know, their own team, because they're not going to be scrimmaging other teams, but scrimmage themselves in their stadium. That way they can kind of get used to what the locker room is like, okay, what the experience is going to be on the field. He also did say that he loves to practice in the grass because he thinks it's healthier and things like that for your body, which we knew about last year and years before. But he says there probably will be a couple of scrimmages that they do in their own building. That way, when they go to play Chicago week one, it's not like, hey, welcome to the stadium, rookies. Like, it's like, okay, they've had a little bit of experience because there is no preseason, right? There's none of those games. So for those guys, it's going to be a new experience. So I definitely agree, you know, especially with all the weird stuff going on. I think that's a great idea to have scrimmages in the stadium. I'm sure they won't let us go watch. I mean, that would be cool, but they probably won't. But either way, I really like the idea there. And then finally, he talked about Jarrad Davis. Now, Jarrad Davis, you know, they declined his fifth-year option. He said when he declined him that he was a cornerstone of the team, but they declined his fifth-year option. They thought that was the best for the team at the time. And he said at this point, he loves what Jarrad Davis could bring to the team next year. He still said that he is a cornerstone of the team again. He used that term again. And he said what he loves about Jarrad Davis is his competitiveness. And now he feels like they have the guys in the building that are also very competitive. Guys like Jamie Collins, Jelani Tavai, Christian Jones, that are going to push him to make him even better. He also says one more year is going to be huge for a guy that's playing a big part of the defense, which he is. He is a big part of that defense. Even though maybe he hasn't played the best, he still utilizes a big part of that defense. A guy that's going to get another year, like Jelani, like Jalen Reeves-Maybin. All these guys, another year. And now working with Jamie Collins. Yes, exactly. The veteran leadership of the linebacker group, working with a guy like Jamie Collins is going to help him grow faster. So hopefully Jarrad Davis plays really well this year. We can be a part of the future of this team. So those are my major takeaways from what Matt Patricia's interview was today. If you guys have any other thoughts that maybe I left out, make sure you let me know in the comments below. And until next time, thank you for watching, and I'm out.